In the previous videos, we discussed several at-risk functions to generate numbers. In this video, we will discuss how to select a suitable random number generator for different scenarios, when the historical data is not available versus when it is available. When past data is not available, we have to rely on the limited available information. For example, if we know the best case and the worst case scenario, or the minimum and maximum values, we can assume that every number in between these two numbers has the same chance to occur. Then, uniform distribution is the most appropriate random number generator. For continuous data, that includes all real-valued numbers, we can use atrisk uniform. For discrete data, that includes only integer-valued numbers, we can use atrisk int uniform. In case we also have most likely case, we can use atrisk pert, atrisk trunc, or atrisk discrete to generate them. This again depends on whether the data is continuous or discrete. If historical data is available, we can let atrisk to feed the data for us and choose the most appropriate random number generator for our datasets.
Two examples here. The first one is going to be for discrete data, and the second one is for continuous data. Okay, so let's take a look at the discrete data here. The discrete data is collected from 100 free throws of a basketball player, as you can see listed on column A. Column B includes all the outcomes of these throws, where 1 represents success and 0 represents a failure. So how would we imitate this player's free throw attempt? So first of all, we want to do that is we want to first highlight only the cells that we try to fit. So that's going to be from B1 all the way to B101. So I'm going to put my cursor here, press and hold the shift control downward arrow that highlights all the cells with numbers in it. After we do that, I'm going to click on fit here. Fit. Okay, I was already working on this spreadsheet, so I got this message. You probably just have to click yes. Okay, in this dialog box, it's essential for us to identify the data type. This data type is 1 or 0, so that's clearly discrete data, so you want to make sure discrete data is selected. You can move on to distributions, which gives us more options here. And we are having parameter estimation, so there are several discrete distributions we have. If you know any of those that you do not want to include, you can uncheck it. For example, if you don't like geometric, you think geometric distribution is not appropriate, you can uncheck it. I'm just going to leave it as it is. Click OK. And so this is the results we get. Okay. So what we have here on the left, several distributions here. And they are sorted with binomial to be on the very top. And this is the most appropriate distribution for our data set. So binomial, followed by integer uniform, Poisson geometric as well. So they were selected in such way using a criteria known as AIC. So we want to minimize AIC, and so binomial is selected. What we also have here is we have blue and red here. Blue is the input. That's the numbers we have from the dataset. And the red one is the one that's simulated using a binomial distribution, a binomial, risk binomial is that. So you can see the red one is the simulated one, and the blue one is our actual data. So you can see they fit quite well. Okay, and if you think this is a good distribution, you can just copy the risk binomial here. You can just click on here and copy it into the Excel spreadsheet you're working on. So it's pretty straightforward. Right. Okay, so this is the first discrete data set. The next one we have is going to be a continuous data set this time. And let's move on to the next one. Continuous data set, what we have here is we have a past 400 returns, 400 daily returns of a company stock. Okay, so there's a lot of data. And what we want to do is we wish to simulate the future returns of the same company. How do we generate returns that are going to be similar to the past returns? So again, we select the data that we want to simulate, we want to fit. So shift control, you hold those two buttons and downward arrow, and you click on fit here. Okay, this time instead of discrete data, you do want to make sure continuous data is checked here. And in distribution, so there are a bunch of distributions here. If you know any of those you do not want to include, you can uncheck them. Okay, and so there's a lower limit and also upper limit. If you do have those information, for example, I know that this company's stock return will not be lower than negative, so I can change it to zero. But this is not the case here. I do not know. So I'm just going to choose unsure here as well. Okay, I'm going to click on OK. Okay, so it's pretty fast. And so those are the distributions we got. Let's take a look. So using AIC criteria again, logistic distribution is the most appropriate distribution for our data set. And followed by Weibo and a normal distribution, if you think those are relevant, or maybe you just want to interest in comparing them, you can select them as well. So you can see I select the three distributions. They are color-coded by blue, red, green. And you can shift this a little bit to the left so you can see how they look like here. So the blue is the actual observation, the 400 daily returns. The red one is the logistic one. That's the one selected by atrisk. And we also selected normal just to see the comparison. So you can see normal is right here, the green curve. And the uniform distribution is the one that we selected just for comparison purpose. It's color-coded as purple. As you can see, purple is somewhat quite different from the actual blue histogram we see, right? Okay, for this particular example, I think both the red curve and green curve fits the data quite well. So I can copy the risk logistic here by just copy them. And I could do the same thing by clicking on risk normal as well. So you can see this is fairly neat.
The following slides are just the screenshots from the video. Please be sure to pause the video and try to practice to fit your datasets using atrisk. Here is a list of the atrisk functions we have learned in this class. The examples where each particular atrisk function has been used are also given here, so you can refer to these examples. This also concludes this video.